Thanks, Pat. The Obama administration promised full disclosure about the agreement with Iran, but some lawmakers are just now learning about secret side deals that could make it even harder to verify if Iran is living up to the deal's obligations. And as Gary Lane reports, that could also make it more difficult for some lawmakers to vote for the plan.
After Defense Secretary Ash Carter tried to change the Israeli Prime Minister's mind about the Iranian nuclear deal, John Kerry lobbied members of Congress on Capitol Hill. The U.S. Secretary of State promised full disclosure of the Iranian nuclear agreement.
We're very much looking forward to answering any and every question that the members of the House have, and then later the members of the Senate.
But despite the administration's pledge of transparency, two congressmen revealed they recently learned about two secret side deals that were made between the UN International Atomic Energy Agency and Iran. Congressman Mike Pompeo and Senator Tom Cotton announced details in a press release. They said the secret deals will not be shared with other countries, Congress, or the public. They apparently involve IAEA inspection of an Iranian military base where nuclear warhead development is proceeding, and PMDs, possible military dimensions of the Iranian nuclear program. The Cotton-Pompeo disclosure forced National Security Advisor Susan Rice to acknowledge side deals were made, involving some sticking points in the negotiations with Iran. The White House will not make details public, but promises to reveal information about the secret deals in a classified briefing with some members of Congress. Congressman Pompeo, a member of the House Intelligence Committee, says the Obama administration agreed to the secret side agreements, and he says without disclosing them, the president is asking the American people to trust but not verify. The intent of that remark was likely to compare President Obama's negotiating skills with those of Ronald Reagan. In December 1987, at the signing of the Intermediate Nuclear Forces deal with the Soviets, President Reagan reminded Mikhail Gorbachev of an old Russian proverb.
Dovayai no provayai. Trust but verify.
На каждой встрече вы это повторяете.
You repeat that at every meeting.
Republicans admired Reagan for standing up to the Soviets and gaining concessions. 28 years later, they're saying secret side deals could make it unlikely to verify that Iran really is complying with this nuclear deal. Speaker of the House John Boehner says he'll do everything he can to stop the Iranian nuclear agreement. Members of Congress will have 60 days to consider and debate the deal before a final vote in September. Gary Lane, CBN News.